showbiz. You're so lame, you're such a bore. I wanna kick your teeth in. Plastic smile to match your...
And Metamorphosis comes out March 24th, and that song is called Hollywood Whore. And I was just talking to the guys during the break, and man, I was way off. I thought, yeah, bands probably are saving so much money making videos because, well, no one's really playing any videos, yeah. But YouTube, you're saying you get more hits on there than you could ever get if eyes were watching MTV if they played a video, right?
Right now, it's great. I mean, the internet is such a huge tool for bands to go promote themselves, and it's like if you go to the right sites and to the right message boards and post up, kids will view it, and we've gotten so many views on Hollywood Whore. Yeah, it's ridiculous. I mean, it wasn't even a single that we pushed at radio, and we play that song live, and it's a hit. And we got a hit, and it was just straight internet. And that's what's really cool.
What about kids singing a song before a record comes out, Jerry? That's got to feel pretty good.
Yeah, it's awesome. You know, even well, we're playing two new songs on this tour, and it's like first few notes, people you can tell they know it already, and then you know once we start singing it,
it goes off. It snaps off the hinges. It feels good. Like it's we've never really been on too many tours like this big route right now with Buckcherry and Avenged Sevenfold. We were just out with Seether and Stain before that, and then we were on Crew Fest. So many tours before an album comes out. So by the time our album drops, we'll play in front of like
a million
people before our album drops. So
they know how to
set
do
up
it.
A record like this.
Do you know in '99 when a bunch of hard music, some it was rock, some rap, and all that, and 90% of those bands, who knows where they are? These guys, 10 years later, are still selling as many records as they did right when they came out.
We are stoked.
Good for
you.
We're
happy.
And by the way, real quick before a call, I've listened to the CD, and there is no hint of a rap at all on this thing.
No, man, I want to prove myself as a valid rock and roll singer on this record. That was the goal. You know,
did you talk to the band about that, or you just...
I mean, it's been a conscious effort over the last couple records, you know, of me just really just pushing myself in a new direction. And I think on this record, I'm stoked with all the performances on this album, you know. And it's like, especially when we had like such a big hit with Last Resort, it's like, how do we top a classic? Like that is a classic of that style. We're like, okay, where do we go from here? Let's evolve. Let's try something new. And it's always a risk, but it's like we didn't want to become a parody of ourselves and just do the same thing over and over, you know. So
nice. It's
art. Progress.
Joe.
Hello.
What's going on, Joe? You're on the radio. Take it away.
I'm having this problem where...
What are you talking about? Yeah, what? Well, tell me.
Well, I don't know if you really want to get onto it on the air, huh?
Oh, yeah, we want to get into it on the air.
I don't know.
Back with the open envelope? Is that what you said?
No, from 2 years ago, an old envelope from a Mac.
Okay, be specific. Get into the story.
I don't know if we want to get it on the air. Joe, yeah. Joe, is your ultimate fantasy have to do with you ejaculating on the pudding and them eating it?
Not so much.
It's you eating the pudding off them.
Mostly, yes.
Okay. All right. Do you have any last words? And are you being serious about this pudding thing, or are you just jerking our chains?
Well, it's a little mixture of both, because I was really interested in talking to Joe. I mean, I'm sorry, Dr. Joe, about this old envelope from a couple years ago with some secret words in it. I don't know if he remembers that or not.
No, all right. We're going to go on that note, though, Joe.
Don't remember.
Nope. All right.
Do not remember.
Uh-oh.
That was bizarre.